C7 Bangor.
This is ABC 7 News at Noon.
A man faces several charges after a standoff with police in Van Buren. Good afternoon, I'm Susan Farley. After lots of delays, a new school in Sullivan is finally open and students are attending classes in person. And there will be more money for child care providers to help make more spaces available for Maine families. Thank you for joining us. We'll have more on these and other stories in just a moment. First, let's check in with meteorologist Devin Biggs. Devin?
Hey, Susan. Happy Thursday afternoon. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Lurgy and Fredericks. Across from Eastern Maine Medical Center, serving the greater Bangor area for over 65 years. A small craft advisory remains in effect until 11 a.m. for your Friday. Gusty winds will continue to be an issue as a cold front continues to move through. And we're not seeing any precipitation. We are done with the precipitation, though, but as this cold front begins to move in, that'll begin to give us some issues as we'll be watching this area of low pressure, this cold front that does continue to move through from time to time. But here we are at this point, though, a lot of sunshine in the way for the rest of today. With falling temperatures, we've already hit our high temperature for the day. We'll have to watch for a little bit more cloud cover as we head near Friday. Here we are, your future cast, showing some of those winds getting up to around 15 miles per hour sustained out of the northwest, pushing in that cooler air. We'll start to back off a little bit as we head towards your Friday. So your forecast for today, middle 60s, decreasing clouds. We've already hit that high temperature with falling temperatures for the afternoon with that northwest wind up to 30 miles per hour. Later on tonight, middle 30s, mostly clear and breezy. Northwest wind gusting up to around 20 miles per hour. For tomorrow, lower 50s, mostly sunny. Northwest wind at around 5 to 10 miles per hour. Hourly forecast for the rest of the afternoon period, a lot of sunshine and falling temperatures. Your full five-day forecast is coming up. Susan?
Thank you, Devin. A man faces several charges after a standoff with police in Van Buren. Maine State Police spokesperson Shannon Moss says just before 9:30 Tuesday morning, Maine State Police got a call from a woman saying her husband was allegedly being assaulted in an unprovoked attack at 154 Castongue Road in Van Buren. The woman and her husband were able to leave the area and get to safety. Moss says when law enforcement arrived, they found 35-year-old Corey Vick inside the residence. Vick allegedly said he had a firearm and would kill any officers if they entered his home. Police tried to contact him by phone. The state police tactical team was called in along with the crisis intervention team. Ma says they worked throughout the night to de-escalate the situation without success. At approximately 6:30 Wednesday morning, the tactical team entered the home and took him into custody. Vick was taken to the hospital for treatment of minor injuries before being taken to the Aroostook County Jail. He is charged with assault, criminal threatening, reckless conduct with a dangerous weapon, criminal mischief, and creating a police standoff. Governor Janet Mills paid a visit to a Dexter-based organization that is keeping Mainers warm as the temperatures drop. Window Dressers is a volunteer-run nonprofit that creates low-cost insulating window inserts. Their goal is to keep their customers warm while also lowering their heating costs. Governor Mills says she's not just a proud supporter of the organization, but also a proud customer.
This is all volunteer, and it's bound to bring down your costs, lower your dependency on oil or other fossil fuels for home heat, and to keep you safe in the winter.
For more information about ordering inserts or volunteering for Window Dressers, visit windowdressers.org. Sumner Memorial High School has finally opened its doors for in-person learning after several months of delay. RSU 24 received a temporary certificate of occupancy after the fire marshals approved plans for installing a sprinkler system. Up until last week, students at RSU 24 were learning remotely through Zoom. Sumner Memorial High School Principal J.T. Green says everyone is glad to be back in person.
This is just an amazing feeling, just to be able to see the kids return from, fortunately, the short stint of remote learning that we endured at the beginning of the school year. It's been great to see them back and to see them in class learning in person.
The construction of the new school began in August of 2016. The process took more than 6 years to complete. The soaring cost of child care has been a major barrier for parents who are trying to return to work after the pandemic. Now, the state is providing millions of dollars in new investment to try to fix the problem. Mel Meyer has a closer look at what the money will actually do.
Providers say that previous investments have helped, but they know
more families need childcare and at an affordable price. The $5.5 million announced by the Mills administration will come from the American Rescue Plan Act. The money will be used for four key areas.
We're going to try to incentivize child care providers to provide infant care. We're going to try to incentivize organizations interested in child care to set up a new child care center.
Maine DHHS also wants more providers to be trained in identifying mental health challenges in children.
So we have incentives for all of the above.
Plus, providers will be incentivized to serve lower-income families by awarding them $500 for each new child served through the Child Care Subsidy Program. This helps eligible families pay for child care so parents can go to school, job training, or work.
That's huge. That's a game changer. It's a game changer for families and for providers.
It helps lower the cost for families, in some cases by up to $180 per week. At the Boys and Girls Club and YMCA of Greater Waterville, they've had more families join the program since eligibility rules were last changed.
We actually have a designated staff position just for that purpose, to get families on the Child Care Subsidy Program.
This has had a ripple effect, allowing them to serve more people in the community.
The more money we recoup from the state, the more we're able to offer help to families that, you know, don't qualify for those kinds of programs.
That was Mel Meyer reporting. The Maine State Police has released a statement that warns of scam callers that use a particular request. In these reported calls, the caller claims to be raising money for the Maine State Troopers Association. They say if you receive one of those calls, just hang up. The Maine State Troopers Association represents the Troopers Union and does not solicit for money. They do, however, conduct fundraisers for charity, but not by using phone calls. Nurses have announced plans to unionize at Bangor's Northern Light Acadia Hospital. The AFL-CIO says 111 staff nurses and advanced practice nurses have filed with the American Federation of Teachers to gain a stronger voice in order to address safe staffing, patient safety, and other workplace issues. The National Labor Relations Board will be scheduling an election for the nurses in the coming weeks, where they will have a chance to decide if they will officially unionize. Northern Light Acadia Hospital told us they have been notified the American Federation of Teachers Union did give them material on October 21st. They say they would prefer a direct relationship with their employees and care teams. They say they do plan to follow the appropriate process for an election. Coming up on ABC 7 News at noon, students are helping Bar Harbor officials detect an invisible threat. We've got details when we return.
Looking to improve or upgrade your home or place of business? With at-home furniture, appliance, and bedding, and kitchen and bath and flooring, we offer a great selection to do just that. From homeowners to commercial businesses and everything in between, our friendly professionals with more than 50 years of combined experience pride themselves in going above and beyond to work with you every step of the way. And we even offer a full-service appliance repair department. Come and visit us at our Dover Foxcroft or our new Lincoln location. Stop in either location today and see what we can do to make you feel at home.
If you've been hurt in a car accident, watch out.
If you wait too long to hire a lawyer, it may hurt your case.
Call the twos and we'll watch out for you.
Lowry and Associates watched out for me and got me $150,000.
I would love to retire. The truth is, because of Joe Biden and Jared Golden's policies, there is no way that I can retire. What Jared Golden does and what Jared Golden says are 180 degrees apart. When Jared Golden goes to D.C., he votes the party line. Gas prices, our groceries. Jared Golden's votes are definitely making inflation worse. We need to make a change. We need Bruce Poliquin.
I'm Bruce Poliquin, and I approve this message.
A Day in the War on the Middle Class by Jared Golden and the Democrats. That day, Jared Golden voted to raise taxes on low and middle income Americans, double the size of the IRS, drive up home heating and gas prices, and empower new regulators who will hurt Maine's lobster industry.
But it's not too late to do something about it.
Yeah, we can stop their war on the middle class. Defeat Jared Golden. The NRCC is responsible for the content of this advertising.
I grew up homeless starting at age 11. I understand what it's like to struggle. Right now, senior citizens, our families, are struggling with high grocery bills, home heating oil prices, and electric bills. I get it. Janet Mills hasn't made it better. She's making it worse. Policies pushing high electric bills, home heating costs, considering gas tax increases. They are just wrong. With your vote, we can fix it.
When the Granite Shop wants to know the weather on MDI, they log on to foxbangor.com. At the Granite Shop in Sedgwick and in Trenton, we have more inventory than all other shops in the state combined. Fastest turnaround, too.
You're watching ABC7 Bangor.
Students in Bar Harbor helping local officials detect an invisible threat. Matthew Jaroncic has more on that story.
The town of Bar Harbor is teaming up with MDI Biological Laboratory in the Connors Emerson School and advising members of the community to test their wells.
We do a project called All About Arsenic, and we work closely with MDI Biolab, where students actually take kits home, test their well water, and the data then comes back to us.
Students would then come back with the information, create trifolds educating the public about the dangers of arsenic in well water. In its second year, Hannah has high expectations for the program.
So the goal this year is to get 100 test kits in the town of Bar Harbor. Last year we had about 35, 36 kits. And again, the kids being more a part of handing out those kits and becoming more aware and talking to townspeople.
The program comes after elevated arsenic levels were detected in more than a tenth of the wells sampled so far.
Arsenic is a huge concern for human health worldwide. And there's this federal MCL limit of arsenic of 10 micrograms per liter that's enforced across Maine.
The kids say it's being able to interact with the community on an important problem that appeals to them the most.
Well, it's kind of fun because we get to do a little experiments and we get to like make posters and trifolds and stuff to help people know if they have like arsenic in their wells.
It really means a lot that we get this opportunity with our young minds to help our community and like share how important it is to test your well water for arsenic.
Matthew Jaroncic, ABC7 and Fox 22.
Thousands of acres of Maine forest land will be preserved thanks to a special purchase. The Frenchman's Bay Conservancy announced it has secured easements on more than 3,000 acres in the Aurora area. A portion of that is in the Union River headwaters and will remain forever wild. According to the Ellsworth American, there are no plans to create trails in the area, but the public will still be able to use it for hunting and fishing. Officials say the purchase is the result of a lot of work by several organizations and landowners who saw the need to conserve their lands as wild. The two easements include an area known as the Whale's Back and will be protected forever. The state of Maine is requiring all schools to test their water supply for harmful chemicals and to make immediate changes if they are found. Devin Dagnall spoke to officials at one of the schools now grappling with this issue.
Large amounts of PFAS were found in the Carville Middle School water supply, and officials are taken aback to say the least.
I think our main concern is that we don't know anything about it.
PFAS are chemical compounds from everyday objects that have contaminated many water sources, not just in the state, but all over the country. According to experts, long-term exposure to PFAS can cause a lot of health complications, many of them serious. According to new Maine state guidelines, all schools must test their water supplies for PFAS contamination and submit their results by December 31st, 2022. After learning of the contamination, RSU 87 acted quickly.
Well, we immediately brought in some water bubblers, so we're supplying drinking water through that. We brought in another water source for our kitchen to cook with. They say we're fine for cleaning and washing hands. So we've taken care of that initially while we try to figure out how to resolve the situation.
Mark Turner, the superintendent of RSU 87, says that the school is still not sure what the plan is for a permanent solution. Turner says the district plans on either working with the state through a grant program or just working directly with local companies to update their filtration system. In the meantime, the school staff is working hard to keep community members and students safe and informed.
We communicated it to the community, to the staff, and to the students. They're middle school students and can definitely handle the information. We put signs up at all of our water sources and worked with all the water fountains to make sure they're not functional.
Carville Middle School principal Nicole Middleswart says students don't seem to be overly anxious about the situation, and the staff says they seem to be rolling with it.
A couple of kids ask questions and we answer it with the same information that we gave the community, and the kids are good with it and go about their day.
In Carmel, I'm Devin Dagnall, reporting for ABC 7 and Fox 22.
New tests also found forever chemicals in a Midcoast Maine watershed. As Brad Rogers found, there's new concern those chemicals may now be contaminating fish as well.
The comprehensive report released by Friends of Merrymeeting Bay provide direct first-time evidence of continued PFAS leakage from the former Brunswick Naval Air Station reaching the watershed.
Well, the question was, in my mind, what's making it to the river?
Ed Friedman and others sampled 30 sites on the Androscoggin and Kennebec Rivers and several creeks that lead to Merrymeeting Bay. He says the testing found 19 different PFAS toxins in the water. The question is, are fish caught in these contaminated waters safe to eat?
PFAS is sort of the new kid on the block, but we've had advisories out for mercury here statewide for many, many years.
Of the 30 sites tested, the highest levels were found in three creeks that drained from the Brunswick Naval Air Station into the Androscoggin River. The highest level was 922 parts per trillion, well above what the EPA considers a safe level. In fact, recent tests on the former airbase found two types of PFAS used in firefighting foams.
When you have an obvious point source like the Brunswick Naval Air Station, and the firefighting foam is probably leaking out still, then you really need to address, you know, when you know where it is, you need to address the problem and you need to address it quickly and effectively.
Testing also found high levels of PFAS in the Androscoggin River, where the Brunswick Sewer District releases treated water.
We're not required to treat for PFAS. We don't even know what that level would be at this point.
Rob Ponteau with the Brunswick Sewer District says he's not surprised by the results. He and Friedman say it's now up to the state to do their own testing and come up with an advisory on eating fish caught in these waters.
It's certainly concerning. There's no doubt, you know, until we know more about the appropriate levels that you can eat in fish and so forth. I mean, I'm an avid hunter, so last year when the state closed down the area around the Fairfield area, that certainly concerned me and most of my staff.
After the break, we'll take a look at some of the ways to get a better night's sleep. That's next. We'll be right back.
I served our country during the Gulf War. We were fighting for freedom in the Middle East. But in Washington, Bruce Poliquin would take away freedoms Mainers have earned. He voted for a nationwide abortion ban and said he supported changing the Constitution. Poliquin would allow politicians to stand between women and their doctors, even in cases of rape and incest. We didn't fight for our freedoms for politicians like Bruce Poliquin to take them away.
DCCC is responsible for the content of this advertising.
I'm Jared Golden. Seeing some Washington politicians try and enrich themselves makes you think of this. That's why I'm working to clean up Congress by banning members from using insider information to trade individual stocks, and why I'm leading the way to stop taxpayer-funded pay raises for Congress. And I'm not taking any PAC money from big corporations that already have too much influence in Washington. I'm Jared Golden, and I approve this message to clean up Congress.
Old Dominion, reigning CMA and ACM Vocal Group of the Year. No Bad Vibes Tour. Saturday, April 15th, Cross Insurance Center. Featuring Whiskey Jam favorites Frank Ray, Cassie Ashton, and Graylin James. Tickets on sale this Friday at Ticketmaster.com. Old Dominion, live in concert. Brought to you by Messina Touring Group.
I was a public health nurse for 29 years. I went into the homes of my neighbors, including many seniors, and cared for them. Then Paul LePage became governor, and everything changed. He kicked seniors off Maine's low-cost prescription drug plan. He cut a Social Security program when it was needed most, and even opposed Meals on Wheels funding. How cruel is that? We can't go back to Paul LePage.
The top funder of Better Maine is the Democratic Governors Association.
Senator Joe Baldacci, hardworking, independent, and effective. Joe Baldacci delivered by helping to pass more than $1 billion in direct tax relief for more than 95% of Maine taxpayers. Joe Baldacci delivered by passing laws to support Maine's small businesses across the board that provided tens of millions in direct relief, helping to protect and save thousands of jobs. Joe Baldacci, hardworking, independent, and effective. Delivering results for Bangor.
Halloween is fast approaching, and some parents are more worried about safety this year. It could mean big changes for trick-or-treaters. ABC's Andrea Fuji explains.
This morning, a new push to make trick-or-treating for weekends only.
We want to make sure that all kids can participate, that it's safe for all kids.
Cincinnati is exploring the option of moving Halloween festivities to a weekend during early evening hours to improve safety for pedestrians and drivers. Supporters say it would also allow more working parents to participate.
We did hear from a lot of people that they want to see it moved, especially seeing other communities make this move as well.
And safety is a legitimate concern. One study found pedestrian fatalities are 43% higher on Halloween, and decades of data shows pedestrians between 4 and 8 years old see a tenfold increase in fatalities on Halloween night. People in Cincinnati aren't the first to consider this idea. In 1999, the editor of the Farmer's Almanac pushed for moving Halloween to Saturday.
If you do it on Saturday, it kind of eliminates the traffic, the business traffic. People don't leave work early to get home, get the costumes, get the children out.
And the Halloween and Costume Association launched a petition to establish a national trick-or-treat day on the last Saturday of October, saying it would promote safety. About 160,000 people have signed the petition. Back in Cincinnati, opponents say moving Halloween is not the answer.
We want utmost safety, but I think we need to do other things to facilitate that specific day and time in which kids actually want to go trick-or-treating instead of the weekend before.
In Cincinnati, Halloween will go on as planned this Monday. And the following Tuesday, council members will examine the possibility of moving future Halloweens. Andrea Fuji, ABC News, New York.
A peaceful night's rest is the key to a refreshing morning. Here are some tips to minimize disruptions that may wake you up at night. ABC's Ike Ijachi has more.
The average person wakes up around 3 or 4 times a night, and they are usually able to fall right back to sleep. However, experts from Harvard Medical School warn that as we age, we can wake up more frequently, leading to lesser quality sleep. To help stay asleep, wear earplugs to reduce noises that may startle you. Eye masks can block light and also produce a calming effect for a peaceful night's rest. Avoid caffeine at least 6 hours before bedtime can help reduce the number of times you may need to wake up to use the restroom. If you do wake up in the night, try to avoid scrolling on the phone or reading a book. Try meditation, deep breathing, or listening to a sound machine to give your body adequate time to fall back asleep. With these tips, you can help minimize disruptions that may wake you up at night. However, another cause of nighttime waking is sleep apnea, in which breathing frequently stops and starts during sleep. Be sure to see your doctor if you suspect you or your partner may have sleep apnea signs of snoring, snorting, restlessness during sleep, or fatigue after a full night's rest. With this Medical Minute, I'm Ike Ijachi, ABC News.
When we return, Devin Biggs has your 5-day forecast.
Our Medicare supplement and drug coverage is so expensive, we're barely keeping up with our bills.
My husband and I were in the same situation, so I got some help from the Senior Planning Center. They were able to show us some high-quality Medicare Advantage plans that saved us a lot of money.
The Senior Planning Center? Tell me more.
They have helpful agents all over the state. Real Mainers helping Mainers. Give them a call. The Senior Planning Center. They were there to help when it mattered most. I'm glad I called them. You'll be glad too.
A Day in the War on the Middle Class by Jared Golden and the Democrats. That day, Jared Golden voted to raise taxes on low and middle income Americans, double the size of the IRS, drive up home heating and gas prices, and empower new regulators who will hurt Maine's lobster industry.
But it's not too late to do something about it.
Yeah, we can stop their war on the middle class. Defeat Jared Golden. The NRCC is responsible for the content of this advertising.
The Biden agenda in Washington is hitting Mainers with historic inflation, and Janet Mills is making things worse. Under Biden and Mills, Mainers will pay 72% more on home heating oil. And with family budgets already stretched to the breaking point, Mills has stretched them even further, imposing a grocery tax that increases monthly bills by $60. Maine families simply can't afford Janet Mills. The top funder of Maine Families First is Thomas Klingenstein.
If you were hurt because of exposure to the toxic water at Camp Lejeune, Congress has made it possible for you to recover a settlement. Former Marine attorney James Beardsley wants to help you.
Call now to see if you qualify. Call 222-2222.
The ABC Fox 22 Spooktacular Sweepstakes is upon us. Go online to foxfangor.com and enter our contest for a chance to win great prizes. Sponsored locally by the Natural Living Center and Village Variety.
Welcome back. The sun has finally returned. Let's check your full forecast with Devin Biggs. Devin?
All righty. Happy Thursday afternoon. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Scott's Recreation, New England's largest trailer dealer, home of Maine's lowest camper and tractor prices, with locations in Turner, Manchester, Herman, and Orono, Maine. All right, as we get things rolling here, a small craft advisory in effect until 11 a.m. for your Friday. We have a cold front moving through with gusty winds up to around 30 miles per hour that are possible today, which is why this advisory is in effect. We have a cold front that's tracking through, and the rain has since ended, though, and it's helped the whole temperatures up. But however, we're going to start cooling things down with this cold front that will begin to move in, but with high pressure right behind it. Some nice weather will be on the way once we get this cold front out of here. That means some cool temperatures on the way later on tonight. So here we are, some gusty winds on the way, getting up to around 25, even 30 miles per hour from time to time today during the afternoon period. Then by later on tonight, those will start to back off slowly but surely. And then by your Friday, things will begin to be a lot nicer. Wave heights are definitely up at around 5 to 7 feet. They were very high earlier, getting up to 10 feet at times, so they're down just a little bit, though, so I'll have to give it just a little bit longer before all this begins to get out of here. Our average high is 54 degrees. We'll reach for the middle 60s today. The lower 50s cooling off for your Friday, then the 50s and 60s kind of stick around for the next several days as we head towards the weekend and even into parts of next week. So future cast moving forward, though, those clouds getting out of here with a lot of sunshine during the afternoon period. Then by tonight, though, a mostly clear sky as temperatures fall into the 30s. And by tomorrow, maybe a few passing clouds, but otherwise a very nice day on the way. So make sure to get outside and enjoy the nice weather on the way. We're dry, at least until Monday of next week. So your forecast for today, middle 60s, decreasing clouds and some falling temperatures as well, with that northwest wind getting up to around 30 miles per hour. Later on tonight, middle 30s, mostly clear and breezy out there still, with that northwest wind up to 20 miles per hour. Moving ahead towards tomorrow, lower 50s becoming mostly sunny. The wind's backing off out of the northwest at around 5 to 10 miles per hour. And your Scott's Recreation extended forecast is now decked out for Halloween, looking pretty nice through Sunday with a mixture of clouds and sun, temperatures in the 50s and 60s. We fall into the upper 50s, though, on Monday with a chance for more rain showers across the area.
Thanks, Devin. Those who visit St. Joseph's Hospital will notice the vibrant new art along the walls. The hospital is displaying the work of local artists as part of a new idea to make the space part hospital, part art gallery. These pieces were installed yesterday by artist Joy Hoy from Stonington. She has 27 works of art on the walls that are mainly oil paintings of the great outdoors.
I think there's a trend in hospitals to go for the healing arts and how nourishing art is, and I think people don't think of it being so.
Many of these paintings depict the Maine coast. Jill wanted to represent a broad section of Maine, but says since she lives in a lobstering community and with their issues with NOAA, she wanted to highlight the lobstermen to some extent. Wow, what a beautiful painting. That's all for ABC 7 News at Noon. Thanks for watching. I'm Susan Farley. We'll see you this evening with Peter Dubois and Beth Jones on ABC 7 News at 6. Have a great afternoon.
I served our country during the Gulf War. We were fighting for freedom in the Middle East. But in Washington, Bruce Poliquin would take away freedoms Mainers have earned. He voted for a nationwide abortion ban and said he supported changing the Constitution. Poliquin would allow politicians to stand between women and their doctors, even in cases of rape and incest. We didn't fight for our freedoms for politicians like Bruce Poliquin to take them away.
DCCC is responsible for the content of this advertising.
You're watching ABC7.